In this particular segment, we're going to take a quadratic spline interpolation method example and see that how it works out to be able to solve one. So here's the example given to us. Go ahead and read it. And what we are asked to find out is that we are given the quadratic spline interpolants which are going through those these five consecutive data points. So you have five data points. There will be four splines. And the first spline has been chosen to be linear while the other three are quadratic. And we are asked to find out what the value of C is in this third spline which is going through the points 4 and 6. So one of the things which we can do is to be able to figure out how we're going to find the value of C by having to set up certain equations based on the understanding that each of these splines are going through two consecutive data points and that the first derivative of the splines is the same at the common points to the to these splines. So what we can do is we can say that at x equal to 4 that the slope of the spline which is the second spline, because that spline and the third spline have the common point x equal to 4, that the slope of the second spline at x equal to 4 is going to be same as the slope of the third spline, because that also goes through 4. And so at x equal to 4, the two splines will have the same slope. What is this? What does that give us? So what that gives us is that that minus 4x plus 14, that is the derivative of the second spline at x equal to 4 will be same as the derivative of the third spline, which is 2bx plus c. But again, keep in mind that the two splines are same at the common point, which is x equal to 4. So this is the common point which we are talking about. So the slope of this is same as slope of this at this common point x equal to 4. So from here we get minus 4 times 4 plus 14 is equal to 2b times 4 plus c, and it is minus 2 is equal to 8b plus c. So that's my first equation. I still have to at least find another equation to be able to find out what the value of c is. And what I'm going to do for that is that I'm going to say that, hey, this third spline and the fourth spline have a common data point at x equal to 6. Well, that means that the slope of this third spline has to be same as the slope of the fourth line at x equal to 6. So that means that the derivative of bx squared plus cx plus d at x equal to 6 has to be same as the derivative of the fourth spline at x equal to 6. Let's go and find out what this is. And what we're going to find out is that 50x minus 303 is the value of the derivative of the fourth spline at x equal to 6. And then 2bx plus c is the derivative of the third spline, and we have to find that at x equal to 6. So what we get is here 50 times 6 minus 303 equal to 2b times 6 plus c, and I get minus 3 is equal to 12b plus c. So that gives me the second equation. And if you remember, the first equation also had only b and c as the unknowns. So I think I'm done with finding the equations which I need in order to find the value of C. So my first equation, which I just found out, was 8b plus c is equal to minus 2. That's equation number 1. Equation number 2 is 12b plus c is equal to minus 3. That's equation 2. So if I solve these two equations to unknowns, I'll get b is equal to minus 0.25, and I get c equal to 0. And since we're looking for the value of C, that's what it is. And that's the end of this segment.